My next guest has a plan to end U.S. reliance on Mideast oil altogether, and it doesn't rely on sending letters to anyone out there. California Republican Congressman Devin Nunes joins us. Congressman, what's your plan?
Neil, basically what we have to do in a nutshell is we have to open up for drilling in ANWR so that we can fill that pipeline back full of oil for the next generation of Americans. We have to drill offshore, including California, including in the Gulf. We shouldn't be going down to Brazil claiming that we want to buy Brazil's oil, although I will admit it's better to buy from Brazil than the Middle East. We also have to look at the oil shale in the Rockies that the Obama administration has put offline. And so what I would like to do, what I'm throwing out there, what I'm talking to the Republican leadership about in the House, is actually as we go to look at this debt limit and raising this debt limit, one thing that should surely be tied to this is oil production, oil drilling in this country so that we can get people back to work and grow the economy.
Well, I know many have argued, you know, got to drill, baby, drill and open up more lands for drilling. You try to tie yours to this whole debt debate. Explain that.
Well, basically, the fastest way to get out of debt is to grow the economy. We cannot grow the economy if we are buying oil from foreign countries and when the Saudis, as you just mentioned today, are willing to essentially say they're going to cut back on production. So that is not a workable solution in this country. I think for too long, not only the Congress, but I think in general, all the eggheads in Washington, D.C. and New York, no offense, Neil, to your folks there, but they ignore energy as if energy isn't a major issue, that we can somehow get all of our energy from solar panels and windmills. I hate to break it to folks, but we have invested hundreds of billions of dollars for 30 years, and what do we have to show for it? 0.5% of our energy comes from solar panels and windmills.
Well,
it's
I
not
understand,
gonna work.
I understand, Congress, you want to start drilling and exploring for oil opportunities here. And you got to start in order to get popping on it. But it does take many years to start realizing oil from any of these venues. So,
But Neil,
I know it takes time.
This is the same thing.
I know we've been debating it for years.
I agree on it,
but we've been debating it for years. But do you think that Republicans could improve their pitch on this argument by exploring all these energy alternatives that the president wants, to call him on that and say, we're even with you on this conservation effort, but it always gets to be each side's way or the highway, and we don't make much progress because you guys quite properly are saying, you know, we think we got to drill more here. The other side is saying, yeah, but you ignore energy alternatives, and on and on and on. Would you be open to some of the other things, Neil, I talked about?
Well, actually, no. When they say, first of all, when they say conservation, what they really mean is rationing. So that's not a way to go. We need a larger supply of energy in this country.
No. Well, I'm talking about stuff like, you know, improve gas mileage in vehicles. That's what.
No, but how much more can we go? But let me tell you what we have done. So part of the energy bill that I put out there with 60 of my colleagues, Republicans, have said that we will take the profit to the government, the royalty revenue, and we will dedicate it into a fund to be used for solar panels, windmills, green sources of energy. I think that is a compromise, because I'm not a big believer that solar panels and windmills actually work in the real world.
Well, wait, where's the compromise?
I am willing to make a commitment.
Where's the compromise there?
Because if you take the oil revenues that would be generated in ANWR and OCS, you put them into a fund that then can be used to bridge ourselves to the next generation of energy, that is a compromise, because that would be the largest commitment by our government in terms of dollars, actual dollars committed to the future renewables that, you know, we may not even know what those are.
Would a compromise also be stopping the tax breaks and credits for oil companies? Would you be open to that?
Well, look, I think that every tax break should be on the table, every tax credit that we have.
What about that?
We should lower the marginal rates.
What about the one I just said?
If you want to get rid of ethanol subsidies, if you want to get rid of all the subsidies and tax credits for all the green renewable energies and everything, yes, then it's okay. But right now, when people talk about tax breaks for the big oil companies, folks need to keep in perspective that puts our oil companies at a disadvantage to Hugo Chavez and the Saudis, because they don't pay the same corporate tax rates in those countries as our corporations have to pay
here.
Well,
I think the argument, I understand what you're saying, Congressman.
Straw man
argument. But I think the argument was, they're making money hand over fist, so they don't need the tax break.
So it's okay to give Hugo Chavez and the Saudis a tax break? I mean, it's a straw man argument because people love to pick on big companies and people that make money. It's no different than when the president went out today and started saying, well, people that are wealthy or that make over $250,000 should pay more in tax. We need to stop the class warfare in this country, and we need to broaden the base, reduce tax rates for all.
That would include the tax breaks for everybody, right? By your definition.
I believe that most companies, no matter who they are in this country, if they would get rid of their,
gotcha,
their tax breaks if they could lower the marginal rates.
Understood. Sir, thank you very, very much.